Good morning, everybody. Honorable Minister of State, respected Deepakji, and Deputy Governor Sri Mundraji, and all dignitaries of the dais, and ladies and gentlemen, very good morning to all of you. Thanks to the governance now for inviting me to this August gathering and sharing my views with regard to that the driving innovations in banking and financial inclusion. Most relevant topic, the financial inclusion, which we have been talking for almost a decade. Probably that we take a little deeper view of it, how to deepen the financial inclusion by driving innovations in the banking or fintech and financial space. The theme has been stated as Cashless India Way Forward. Rather, I would ask, Mr. Hotaji rightly set the stage, it is not the cashless, it may be to begin with less cash society. Why it is a less cash? You all know the cash has its own, the most characteristic prime of anonymity. The moment it moves out of my hand, you are not able to track it. That is one thing which is being adored, or rather accepted by each and every one of you, right from the village, right, or right up to the corporate level. That being the case, when we try to move about less cash society, what is a compelling reason? One of the major reason is our cash to GDP is highest in the world. As has been said by Mr. Hotaji, huge amount is being spent for printing the cash, circulating the cash, managing the cash, and maintaining the cash by various authorities, including the regulators and the government. It is nothing but natural to bring about the lesser impact of this particular expenditure, which is just all pervasive in the society, and move towards alternates. What are the alternates in front of us? Everybody knows that digital is one of the major alternates. Why so? Let us look around. The biggest invention of the human mankind, we say, is the internet. In India, in 2001, approximately 7 million internet users were operating in our country. It increased by 30 times within 15 years. Look at the phenomenal adoption which is taking place. Maybe this is one of the disruptive innovation which is just moving or making us to adapt. It became a way of life for many, and take the smartphone away from many of us, probably we will be like without a hand and we'll feel restless. We may not be able to carry forward with day-to-day course itself. Almost 50 million Indians use internet 50 hours a month. Imagine the power of internet to glue which they have. Now what is next? We need to catch their eyeball attention in order to bring about the alternate to what we have been talking about, the less cash society. Over the net application is the talk of the day. It is triggered by the internet presence, and its adoption were the first stream of innovation. The net has created a new business model, new business verticals like social media. Over the net application is just driving the net neutrality, which is the very hot topic of the day, and it has been triggered again in US mainly because to have data to be treated as a data. The moment we wanted to move towards less cash society, probably we start looking at money as a data. The technology will move the data from one place to another place. When we start moving the money also as a data, probably we will move towards a position of less cash. E-commerce platforms are shifting the users from shopping in the store to shopping on the go. The internet user community in India is growing exponentially. It's mind-boggling to note, first 20 years saw 100 million users hooked onto the net. Next 3 years saw 100 million. I'm pretty sure next 1 year it is predicted that 100 million will be hooked on. Look at the pace and the rate at which it is being adapted. Probably that is one of the major disruptive force which all of us have to look at very closely, be it a service provider or be it the service availing public or those who are providing the technology, which is the bridge between the receiver and that of the provider. The reason for the exponential growth is not due to only adoption at the metros. It is the penetration or expansion in rural India, small towns. The most important thing is increased affordability of the devices and increased affordability of the data plan, which is being rolled out day by day. The increase will go multifold, as predicted, one of the major reasons being adapting the internet in the vernacular languages, which will ensure that it is being accepted across by the people who matters in order to move to the less cash society. Habit and way of doing things have changed. We are in the era of change, continuous change, and change is only constant. Internet has the power to impact our life. Its impact in consumption, education, entertainment, interaction with the family and friends. The days are not far off, or it's happening even today. The family members talk to themselves through WhatsApp, staying under the same roof. Access to the financial facilities, financial services, connectivity at work. It is a game changer. Consumers having a net connection first go online. You all know, before going into the shop to get the feel of buy, we first have a look of the buy and see what exactly the... You go to some of the malls which we see today, they have put the QR code, the people scan it, which hooked on to their own online stores. You have a feel at the store and buy it online with the discount. That's the order of the day. This kind of disruption is not taking place in the financial services. That may be one of the reasons that we are not able to deepen the products and services to the last mile. They make informed purchase decisions. As they become more comfortable, their usage pattern grows. That defies age, demographic variables. It enhances productivity and efficiency and facilitate organization to reach the segment which were hitherto denied the access to such products and services. We say financial inclusion is bankable, and the people who are provided with is bankable. I can share RBI data, or in the presence of Mundraji, it is not fair to roll out the data because we just take the data from them. Every individual financial FI account which we opened, 27.84 crores of account which has been done in the mission mode, crores of rupees have been brought into the formal system, which was hitherto were in the pajamas or in the pots. It is impacting the livelihood and quality of life, driving increased engagement. Thus, we can understand the biggest alternate digital platform to cash economy. The digital way of life is being leveraged to move towards less cash society. Government of India is unwinding the potential with its JAM program. The Jan Dhan Yojana, you all know how it has been brought about the biggest change in the way we have been banking today. And it provided, in a mission mode, it brought in the most excluded or unbanked or underbanked society into the mainstream banking. The Aadhaar, the biometric-based identity, it's a binding factor. With its unique features, establish the much-needed physical identity of the individual. We probably will have two things to be identified today, my mobile number, my Aadhaar number. With that combination, probably every individual will be known. Maybe the days are not far off where I will be known by my mobile number and Aadhaar number, not by the name. It will establish the right of the individual in the foolproof mechanism. The most disruptive adaption of the technology in our century is the mobile. Indians across the spectrum jumped the curve and started using internet, using the mobile rather than the PC. Rest of the world was working on PC and PC. We just jumped to the tablets as well as to that of the mobile. So the entire focus today is mobile. There is a very famous adage, Dunia Mutti Mein. Way back we heard it. Really, it is the entire banking, it's also in Mutti. Every other aspect has come on your palm. The face of the new online India will be markedly more diverse. The mobile phone will be the primary, rather only access point. The services will match the day-to-day demand of the low to middle income household. Most of the services will be vernacular heavy. The key elements to unlock this potential: affordable access, be it financial services, or be it any other services which we are offering today. Affordable data enabled devices, you are seeing the rate which is just moving south with regard to the smartphones, which are costing somewhere around 80-90,000, is costing 9,999. To that extent, it has come down. The internet plans. When these things are slashing, I'm just throwing open to my banker colleagues as well as to others who are associated, why we should charge the MDR at all? Let us try to disrupt and then see what disruptive ways we will be able to make money other than what we are charging out of it. There are n number of ways I can do it. All of us can sit together and find out that 1.78 or 0.25 or 0.30 percentage is not going to give me the cost which I'm investing, but at the same time is provide me a better opportunity for penetrating much deeper. Why it is being said so? Today I'm comfortable with the cash. If I have to move out of the cash and adapt the alternative of the digital, what incentive I am having today? Why should I shift when I am comfortable with the cash? It's a question which is foremost. Lot of rather innovative ways have been adapted by government by providing incentives to the users, incentive to the referrals. Today there is a referral incentive is also being provided. These are all the game changers with regard to bringing in more and more. And this is a time where we have to think of, every bank can think of alternatives. Like you get the credit card today from any of the banks, they say that I give you a X number of JP miles, we get the card, but majority of us may not even use it. But still we have a mindset of accepting that card because I get a 10,000 JP miles associated with that card. Why don't you bring in the concept of reward points for each and every transaction which is being done on digitally, and provide them an opportunity, hook them onto a system again and again for with that the reward points, which can be encashed by them for the white goods. The ecosystem will start delivering when we move forward. This is one thought I just placed before this gathering. We can discuss and deliberate on that, take it forward. Facilitating digital transaction and easing the payments, potentially through new instruments. We are seeing the wallets. The wallets have changed the way we have been paying it, the discounts which are attracting it. It hooked on. Today, the youngster, with the college-going youngster, or the one who is just stepping into the job, he uses the wallet. The digital is so adapted. Why it cannot pervade in other areas? A lot of changes have been brought in by the regulators. Government is also encouraging, our Hotaji said about, the most disruptive innovation which has come in this century by NPCI is IMPS. The days were, just imagine a century back, you wanted to transfer a fund for a son of yours who is studying in Manipal University elsewhere in Bangalore. You need to wait, do an exclusive banking. Walk into the bank branch between 10 to 5 or 10 to 3 or 10 to 2, get the DD taken out, dispatch it, look at the time value of your efforts. Today, this IMPS facilitates the transfer 24/7. With this, nothing else can be a disruptive innovation than this. We can move forward by collaborating these products and services in other offerings, what we are doing it today. We have a BIM, you have a UPI. The BIM application adoption in the rural area is higher, and it is increasing day by day for its ease of using. Reaching the semi-urban and rural segment is achieved by making it simpler and easier to do, and coupled with some incentives. India jumped the curve in internet use by skipping PC and adapting mobile as media. The demand has created a big market for mobile handsets and drove the data plan at easy payment terms. The critical element in this journey is the network availability. Government of India's NOFN, the National Optical Fiber Network Project, is to provide the broadband connectivity to all gram panchayats. As we speak, by end of this year, it is being said that 150,000 panchayats will be connected and provided with the broadband. What else is required than this penetration? Now it is for the service providers to make use of this platform to penetrate and then offer the services. Having created the ecosystem and facilitating the digital transactions, banks and the payment systems are to be integrated with the commerce. Cash with its ease of use is preferred by small business. But if the digital cash is to be introduced to the small business and the users making the payment is to be attracted to the alternate. A lot of incentives, as I said, has been made. And as we move forward, the most important component of this entire system is the banks. because they provide, they're the backbone for the economy, the driving force for the inclusive growth for adapting digital transaction. What is preventing today from adoption than what it is the percentage? Although it is increasing, but still, large segment is still not have made use of all the features which all of us sitting here are using it because of lack of awareness. Mr. Hotaji made a mention about it. Aware of the products, aware of the services, aware of its benefits which is associated with that. The last leg or the last mile has to be penetrated. You can think of, we have a mobile ATMs, we have a mobile branch. You can think of a mobile BC with a customized van with your recycled CDM, with a passbook kiosk, where you have a TV which keeps talking about your recorded speech about the features. And there are FLCs in the banks. Literacy. There was a literacy week which was conducted in the month of July by Reserve Bank of India and adopted by all the banks. Efforts were made to penetrate the rural segment to make them know about it. But is it sufficient? It is not sufficient as on today for the simple reason. The disruption or the confidence level of the user has to be boosted. My appeal to the media friends is that we always have a mind or rather eye-catching headlines. 32 lakhs cards have been compromised. No doubt, you have to bring it to the knowledge of the people to bring about that what is happening. But can it be coined in the other way around? When 99.5 or 99.8% of the cards are secured, why this 0.3% of the cards cannot be secured? Look at it and then try to do it. This will make the people to feel, yes, everything is not bad as it is presumed to be. One simple message derails or rather set back months and months of efforts to bring in the confidence. The first time user step out, it is like making three steps forward and four steps behind. So everybody in the ecosystem has to contribute to this positive vibe and make everybody to feel the confidence. Higher the confidence level at the rural segment, the better will be that. Now the innovation users has looking at something similar to omni-channel. ATM is giving cash. Internet banking is working. Mobile banking is working. If I do a registration on internet banking, I need to do the re-registration in my mobile banking again. Why? Why can't we look at the service providers and the fintech companies who are coming with the disruptive innovations? They can join together, come with the omni-channel. Look at the situation where I start my banking transactions or any other related transaction on my laptop at home, walk into my car and continue with my mobile. And it gets disrupted due to the disruption. My call center calls up auto. We have a artificial intelligence and that in our call center triggers a call, facilitate me to start from where I left it and walk into the office and use my desktop to complete the transactions. Omnichannel is something which is the future. Probably a step towards that will reduce the cost further down. And I'm sure that our innovation, our service providers and some of the technology companies can look at it along with the bankers. The smartphones have come as a way of life. Today, it is penetrating everybody. And every application, in my own organization, if I want my employees to read the circulars and guidelines which is being provided for them, finding it extremely difficult even if you put it on the internet and online. What is required? You make it as a part of WhatsApp which they are hooked up otherwise also. Provided as part of the mobile, the e-learning concept. Your push facility of the products and services in nutshell, facilitating them to read it. As I said, exclusive banking has gone. Now also banking is the concept. I go to petrol pump, I have to fill up my petrol, which is essential. Petrol cannot come to my home. I have to provide the banking at the place where I do my essentials. I go to the mall, I just do the transactions there. There we will be in a position to do the also banking. The more and more of also banking is introduced, deeper and deeper will be the penetration. I'm sure the challenges are many. The most important challenge is providing the secured connection. The very, very important aspect is bringing in the confidence amongst the users. The lack of security awareness, the digital or the digital awareness, or the digital literacy. As our Hotaji said that less than better with regard literacy. It's a high time we have to penetrate this. If at all we wanted to be a successful in our journey of the digital, the everybody sitting across in this must have the responsibility of creating awareness about the products and services, else the social engineering technique, the phishing, will take away the hard-earned money. You need to have a mechanism by which you have very clear-cut tracking of it. There are certain intelligent software which some of us have adapted, makes us to feel an ATM card provided at, let us say, an interior village in Tamil Nadu, somewhere in Kumbakonam, is tried to be made use of in Assam. You block it, provide it to them, and get in touch with the people. These are the things. A person who doesn't even have a passport, is a card is being used in China. Do we have a countervailing mechanism to stop, identify, and prevent it? In fact, the cyber security has been identified and understood as one of the most important element in our journey towards digital, with the Reserve Bank of India, and as well as the government is attaching so much of importance to it, and exclusive policy frameworks have been drawn for it. We need to have a lot of mitigants to address this area and concern. Constant upgradation, continuous surveillance is the hallmark of digital cash. Let us go green and go digital, and our journey towards this will be a great successful. Thank you all. Thank you to the governance now for providing me an opportunity. Thank you.